Hello everyone, today I'm going to present you our paper that was published in the Journal of Biological Chemistry in October 2019. For this study, we addressed the relationship between tropomyosin-related kinase receptor TRKB and the adaptor complex protein AP-2 and how their interaction can be regulated by the antidepressant drug treatment. From the studies in the literature, we know that the action of antidepressant drugs in the brain is complicated, and these drugs can induce changes in the brain that we would like to call drug-induced plasticity. Looking at neurons closely in the brain, researchers have identified these plastic changes at many levels. For instance, these drugs can promote generation of new neurons, and at the same time, they can eliminate the cells that do not work properly. Moreover, they can induce structural changes that could eventually affect the functioning and the communication between neurons, as you can see in B, C, and D. Expression of genes can also be affected by the drug treatment, as you can see in E. Of course, once these drugs reach into brain, they need to act on specific targets in order to induce the changes I was talking about in the earlier slide. TRKB receptor, illustrated in this slide, is one of these drug targets. Activation of this receptor by drugs can induce downstream signaling pathways that could mediate the drug-induced plasticity in the brain. However, TRKB receptor does not act alone, and its ligand, brain-derived neurotrophic factor, BDNF, as well as other proteins, help this receptor to play its role for the drug action to take place. Up to date, there is not much known about these proteins that help TRKB receptor to mediate drug-induced plasticity. Therefore, in the present study, one of our initial aims was to identify TRKB receptor complex proteins which are regulated by antidepressant drug treatment. After identifying a list of proteins, we put a special focus on the AP-2 complex. Moreover, we addressed other key downstream players to determine the fate of TRKB receptors and the AP-2 complex. Briefly, we used mass spectrometry to identify protein coupling, uncoupling to TRKB receptor in hippocampal samples that were acquired from adult mice after acute fluoxetine treatment. Co-IP, Western blotting, and sandwich ELISA methods were used in order to address the TRKB receptor AP-2 complex interaction. Surface ELISA was implicated to address cell surface expression of TRKB receptors. And immunostaining was utilized to address the fate of TRKB receptors. As study material, we used mouse brain samples, MG87 TRKB cell line, and neuronal cultures that were prepared from embryonic rat brain. Following saline or acute fluoxetine treatment, hippocampus from mice were collected and processed for TRKB co-immunoprecipitation in order to elute TRKB receptor interacting proteins. Samples from saline and fluoxetine treated animals were compared after mass spectrometry. The interaction of some complex proteins with TRKB receptors were found to be reduced after fluoxetine treatment. We found that the AP-2 complex subunit proteins were co-immunoprecipitated with TRKB, and their interaction with the receptor was also reduced. Briefly, AP-2 complex is a clathrin-associated endocytic adaptor protein. The complex consists of four small subunits that are involved in different tasks. The co-region with mu and sigma subunit recruits the whole complex to target membranes, while the hinge appendage portion that consists of alpha and beta subunits facilitate interaction with clathrin, other adapters, and accessory proteins. Furthermore, we confirmed with Western blotting and ELISA that the interaction of TRKB with AP-2 complex is indeed reduced. Moreover, such reduction of interaction can still be observed after 7 days of treatment with fluoxetine. We addressed putative binding sites between TRKB receptors and AP-2 complex subunits. For this purpose, we used ELM, eukaryotic linear motif library, and tyrosine-based motifs particularly the one that includes tyrosine 816 at C-terminal of TRKB receptor, has been suggested by this library as a putative binding site for the AP2 complex subunit mu. I will refer to this subunit as AP2M after this point. We use docking simulations to test the binding of the last 26 amino acid sequences from the C-terminal of TRKB to AP2M and found that the binding energy is the lowest when this peptide is phosphorylated at the tyrosine residue, as you can see in the red. On the other hand, the energy needed for this binding to take place was higher than the control peptide when the tyrosine residue was mutated to alanine, as you can see in blue. In vitro testing of simulations in MGTRKB cell line verified our docking simulations. In the next step, we addressed the effect of silencing of AP2M subunit in MGTRKB cell line. We challenged the cells with BDNF in order to observe the changes in the TRKB receptor signaling. Although not significantly, basal TRKB level was reduced in MGTRKB cells. On the contrary, we observed increase of TRKB receptor phosphorylation at different tyrosine residues here and here, except the 515 tyrosine. Moreover, the cell surface expression of TRKB was enhanced in the AP2M silenced cultures. Hippocampal protein analysis of mice, which were haploinsufficient for AP2M, was in line with the findings of the cell culture. In the cultures prepared from these animals, we observed that the TRKB receptor surface expression was also increased. At this step, we went back to addressing the drug-induced changes in the TRKB-AP2 complex interaction. In addition to fluoxetine, we tested drugs from different classes: imipramine, a tricyclic antidepressant; rolipram, a selective phosphodiesterase 4 inhibitor; phenalzine, a monoamine oxidase inhibitor, were able to reduce the interaction of these two proteins. In addition to these classical slow-acting antidepressants, the rapid-acting antidepressant ketamine and its metabolite 2R6R hydroxynorketamine were able to induce the same effect. Negative controls, aspirin, an antipsychotic drug chlorpromazine, and enzyletic diazepam failed to induce any changes. Fluoxetine and imipramine facilitated the surface recruitment of TRKB receptors after a brief challenge and also longer exposure, as you can see, as 15 minutes and 2 hours. Next, we show that the blockade of TRKB receptor phosphorylation by K252A was not able to affect the drug-induced disruption of these proteins, while BDNF-induced coupling of TRKB with the AP2 complex depends on the phosphorylation of the receptor. We also addressed a putative action site for drugs on these proteins. In a cell-free ELISA setting where the treatment is done after cells were lysed, fluoxetine was able to reduce the interaction between TRKB and AP2 complex. On the other hand, when we tested C-terminal peptide of TRKB in the same setup, fluoxetine did not induce any effect, suggesting that the binding site might be located on the TRKB receptor upstream regions. We also found that fluoxetine disrupts TRKB AP2 complex interaction in cortical and hippocampal neurons. Then we addressed other endocytic markers in order to understand the fate of TRKB receptors after acute drug treatment. We started with RAB5, which is an early endosomal marker. However, we did not see any changes in the colocalization of TRKB receptor with RAB5 in neurites or spines. Next, we investigated RAB7 TRKB colocalization, as RAB7 has been found to be a late endosomal marker. We detected increase of RAB7 TRKB colocalization in spines, but not in neurites after fluoxetine treatment. As the last target, we addressed RAB11, which has been suggested to recycle TRKB receptors back to cell surface. We failed to detect any changes in the colocalization of TRKB and RAB11. In the present study, we observed differential regulation of the TRKB AP2 interaction by BDNF and the antidepressant drugs. BDNF promotes their interaction while the drugs disrupt it. We found that the site of interaction with the AP2 complex overlaps with the same tyrosine residue that is targeted by antidepressant drug-induced phosphorylation. It is possible that the removal of AP2 complex by drugs may allow recruitment of other proteins. Altogether, our data suggests that disruption of the TRKB AP2 interaction is a common mechanism underlying TRKB activation by several chemically diverse antidepressants. In the present study, we show that the drug treatment increases cell surface expression of TRKB receptors. Cell surface or endocytic compartments are the two possible sites for the drug-induced TRKB AP2 disruption to take place. Lack of changes in the colocalization with RAB11 positive recycling compartments suggest that TRKB AP2 complex disruption is likely to take place at the cell surface level to maintain high level of receptors at this site. However, increased colocalization with RAB7 in spines, but not in neurites, suggests that there is TRKB receptor regulation at endocytic level, which may work towards maintaining the local TRKB signaling by delaying the transport towards soma via RAB7 positive endosomes and rescuing degradation in lysosomes. Necessity of full-length TRKB in order to observe disruption of TRKB AP2M interaction points that there might be a binding site for these drugs on TRKB receptors. Indeed, in our other study, which is available in bioarchive, we observed that TRKB receptor transmembrane region provides a pocket for the drug binding. While finishing my talk, I would like to thank our laboratory members and collaborators for their contribution to our work, and also our funding agencies for helping to make this work happen. Thank you.